The controversial former workers representative, Dr. Sam Liomoki, showed up to the NSSF probe committee where he had vowed not to return, accusing the committee of bias. Liomoki, now an NSSF board member and the secretary general to Central Organization of Trade Unions, made his way to the conference hall where the inquiry happens in parliament. As the committee started, the Bwamba County MP Richard Gafabsa brought to the attention of the committee a letter written to the speaker in which Sam Liomoki accused the committee of bias and posturing, vowing not to return to the probe. The
committee is merely a posturing and a space for public humiliation. The committee, not Honorable Bakavulindi, public humiliation and injury of my integrity and that of my colleague and Deputy Secretary General Ms. Penina Tukamwesiga, in order to sanitize an already concluded decision against us.
Going to withdraw that statement.
The committee pushed Liomoki to withdraw a statement if he's to appear before them. They questioned him of his bias allegations and asked the chairperson Mwine Mpaka to accord him time in absence of Bakabulindi.
And there's evidence about a police case where he tried to worked with him. They told him I should go and meet them. Then later we meet. We tried to meet and then they said that I wanted to kill him. It isn't the police. And this is one of the allegations that I wanted to kill someone. This is my brother whom they
So, Dr. Liomoki.
So, for me, I basing on that, even all these things that we are hearing about COF2, because there have been some issues between the two centers. And my brother there has been funding unions to come from this side and this side. And there is evidence to that.
The letter I wrote to you is not complaining about me alone. It's also complaining about the integrity of the committee. And your question was clear.
Clearly, because an officer of a corporation is named to be the authority, does not by itself bring into force or operation the doctrine of no man can be a judge of his own case. Therefore, by Honorable Baka being a member of this committee by authority, would not by itself mean bias.
He maintained his stand and was forced to exit the meeting.
In terms of the reference to the whole committee, that one, I can withdraw the reference to the whole committee. But in terms of the whole, as long as my brother is there, it's really
you see, I don't know.
It's already a conflict of interest, but we can. I am waiting for the response from the speaker, but in terms of that reference, that conclusion about the whole committee, it will depend on, for instance, how to operate.
Withdrawn because you are conditioning your withdrawal on something that has not yet happened. If at all, I will see this time. So I'm going to ask you, Dr. Liomoki, to kindly leave this committee.
Thanks very much, Honorable Chair.
The committee proceeded to grill members of the NSSF board over the contentious 1.8 billion shillings under corporate social responsibility budget. Whereas the former MDB Arugaba said the budget was approved due to pressure from politicians and the board, board members denied the claim and threw it to Arugaba.
You under pressure to pass this corporate social investment that had incorporated monies, some to the board, some to the chairman, and some to the minister. From the fund, were there these discussions?
There were discussions in the board, like you've seen in the minutes, for the corporate social investment budget. There were probably misunderstandings between the board and management on the intentions, the intended usage of the budget. That's a fact as well.
The committee discovered that board members and Minister Betty Amongi shared the money between themselves, with the minister getting 250 million shillings and 200 million shillings for chairperson board and 400 million shillings for each workers union for donations.
It is a new fund you created. You changed and called it corporate social investment. So the chairman of the board, you have been allocated 250 million to donate as and when you wish, and this money cannot be accounted for. The whole board, you have been allocated 500 million to donate how and when you think you want, without accountability. You have also given the Honorable Minister of Gender, Honorable Betty Amongi, 250 million to donate how and when she feels like.
How did you arrive at the 1.8 billion that you passed in your budget? How did you come up with this figure? How you just randomly came up with any figure? Because I thought the work plan comes before you do the budget.
So far, there have been questions about the 2.6 billion shillings lost through controversial procurement of unused smart card technology, the unrecovered 20 billion shillings bad debt extended to the loss making Uganda Clays Limited in 2010, the exorbitant 4 plots of land whose titles have never been transferred, and now the 1.8 billion shillings. Other queries include the 6 billion request by the Minister of Gender Betty Amongi and the unprofitable investments including Lubowa Housing Project. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.